Let's do a very interesting phenomenon termed as self-induction. Before that, let's understand this experiment. What is there in the experiment? This is battery connected, key, and resistance is connected with one bulb V1 in series, and inductor coil is connected with another bulb V2 in series. Now, when we plug in key K, we observe as soon as we plug in key K, the bulb V1 glows instantly. However, the bulb V2 takes some time to glow. Similarly, when you plug off the key or switch off the key, the bulb V1 it stops glowing instantly. However, the bulb V2 stops glowing slowly and slowly. It does not stop glowing instantly. It means the coil has tendency, the moment you switch on the key, inductor coil develops an induced EMF when current passes through the coil, and it realizes change in magnetic flux. Because current is increasing in the coil from 0 to its maximum value. And according to Lenz's law, we know it always opposes the cause. So it induces an EMF to oppose the increase in magnetic flux. And this actually makes a delay for glowing bulb V2 instantly. Similarly, when you remove plug of key K, or you can say key is switched off, the current in the inductor coil suddenly drops to zero. Right? So magnetic flux linked with the coil also decreasing towards zero. So it reverses the direction of EMF, because the tendency of induced EMF is always opposes the cause. When flux increases, its tendency is to decrease it. When flux decreases, its tendency becomes to increase it. That's what it means. An inductor coil has tendency to set up an induced EMF across it. The current is flowing through the same coil. The coil starts realizing that there is some change in magnetic flux linked with it, and it gets induced. That's why it is termed as self-induction, getting induced by itself. So how can we define this self-induction? It is the property of a coil by virtue of which coil opposes any change in the strength of current flowing through it by inducing an EMF across it. Right? So what is the definition? It is the property of a coil by virtue of which a coil develops and a coil opposes any change in the strength of the current flowing through it by inducing an EMF across it. Now, the magnetic flux linked with coil phi is directly proportional to the current flowing through it. So phi is equal to Li, where L is called coefficient of self-induction, or self-inductance. SI unit of self-inductance is Henry. And you can define self-inductance from here itself. If I is equal to 1 ampere. This implies L is equal to 5. Thus, you can form a sentence. We have done so many times up here also. I can give you sentence again. Thus, coefficient of self-induction is numerically equal to the magnetic flux linked with the coil when 1 ampere current flows through it. And if you want to define 1 ampere, then put phi also equals to 0. Differentiating this equation, differentiating equation 1 with respect to t, what you will have? D phi over dt is to L di over dt. Introduce minus sign both the sides. What you will have? E is equal to minus L di over dt. So this is induced EMF. If di over dt is equal to 1 ampere per second and E is equal to 1 volt, this implies L is equal to 1 Henry. So I think you can write definition of 1 Henry now. How do you define 1 Henry then? Coefficient of self-induction or self-inductance is said to be 1 Henry when current changes at the rate of unity through a coil inducing an EMF of 1 volt. I repeat, the coefficient of self-induction of a coil is said to be 1 Henry when current changes at the rate of unity through the coil inducing an EMF of 1 volt. Right? Let's see the expression for self-inductance. Expression for self-inductance. Consider a coil. Consider a coil of length L. You can call it as solenoid also. Long solenoid you can use. Area of cross section A. And having N number of turns. When I current flows through a coil, magnetic field produced mu naught Ni, where N is the number of turns per unit length. This you can write it as mu naught Ni over L, because capital N is total number of turns. Now this magnetic field will pass through the same coil. Therefore, magnetic flux linked with coil phi is equal to NBA, total number of turns, magnetic field and A, that you can put it as mu naught n square a I over l. We already know the formula comparing with formula which we have derived is equal to Li, then L is equal to mu naught n square a over L. So what are the factors on which coefficient of self-induction of a coil or self-inductance depends? Number one, medium. Mu naught here is for when there is an air in between in the coils of a solenoid. N are the total number of turns. A is area of cross section and L is the length of a conductor. So these are the factors on which it depends. Self-induction, which is a phenomenon basically related with a single coil. We have mutual induction also, and mutual induction is the phenomenon which is obviously related with two coils or more coils, because you are very much familiar, I think, with the word mutual interaction, right? We mutually have decided. When we make a statement like this, mutual interaction, or we have mutually decided, it cannot be a single person taking decision. It is always minimum two or more than that. Right? Now, so there must be a two coils. So you can take two coils. There is a one coil having n number of turns, and you can give opening here to this coil, connect it with EMF source coil 1 and keep another coil close to it. This is also having another number of turns, coil 2. Now what is observed when you make a current to pass through the first coil 1 or coil number 1, you will find EMF is induced in the second coil. Of course, it will be possible only when coil 2 is placed close to the coil 1. Close to, I sense here that it must be within the range of magnetic field produced by the coil 1. If it is outside the region of magnetic field produced by the coil 1, there will be no mutual induction. So, how do we define mutual induction? Now, instead of talking about a single coil, we will say two coils. It is a property of two coils by virtue of which each coil opposes any change in the strength of current flowing in the neighboring coil by developing an EMF across it. I repeat it quickly now. It is a property of two coils by virtue of which each coil opposes any change in the strength of current in current flowing in neighboring coil by inducing an EMF across it. Right? So consider I current passes through the coil 1. If I be the current flowing through the coil 1, through coil 1, then flux linked magnetic flux linked with second coil linked with coil 2. So phi b s or coil 2 directly proportional to the current in the first coil. This says phi b 2 is equal to m I 1, where m is termed as m is called coefficient of mutual induction. Or mutual inductance. ऐसा यूनिट ऑफ म्यूचुअल इंडक्टेंस इज ऑल्सो हेनरी. रिमेंबर दिस. यू कैन अगेन डिफाइन म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन इन द सेम मैनर. इफ आई वन इज इक्वल टू वन एम्पियर, दिस इंप्लाइज कोफिशिएंट ऑफ म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन इज इक्वल टू दिस. बट ओनली द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेंटेंस विल लिटिल वेरी, द लैंग्वेज विल वेरी, because there is an involvement of two coils. So how do we go about it? Listen me carefully. Thus the coefficient of mutual induction between two coils, coefficient of mutual induction between two coils, numerically equal to the magnetic flux linked with the second coil. Magnetic flux linked with the second coil when 1 ampere current flows through the first coil. I repeat, coefficient of mutual induction between two coils is numerically equal to the magnetic flux linked with the second coil when 1 ampere current flows through the first coil. Right? As far as SI unit is concerned, SI unit of mutual induction is again, coefficient of mutual induction is also Henry. Same as you have seen in case of self-induction or self-inductance. You can again differentiate this equation, differentiating with respect to T. What you will have? D phi B 2 over dt is equal to m di1 over dt. This, if you introduce minus sign both the sides, so this equation becomes E is equal to minus dm I over dt. This is in second coil. Or you can put it as secondary coil also, doesn't matter. So if di1 over dt is equal to 1 ampere per second, E2 is equal to 1 volt, this implies M is equal to 1 Henry. So you can again define in the same manner. Thus, coefficient of mutual induction between two coils, is said to be 1 Henry when current changes at the rate of unity in the one coil. When current changes at the rate of unity in the first coil and induces an EMF of 1 volt in another coil. I repeat. Mutual inductance of the coil is said to be 1 Henry, or mutual inductance between two coils is said to be 1 Henry when current changes at the rate of unity in the first coil induces an EMF of 1 volt in other coil. Right? That's how you will write. Let's see the expression of mutual inductance. Expression for mutual inductance between two coils. I kept the same figure here. Coil number of turns in this coil are N1, in this coil are N2. Current here flowing is I. That's all. Area of cross section of this coil is A. Few more parameters, N1, N2 are number of turns in coil 1 and 2 respectively. L is the length of the coil. 1. A is area of coil. 1. Area of coil 2. Consider current I is flowing through the coil 1. Then magnetic field produced by coil B equals to mu naught N1 over L into I. Therefore, magnetic flux linked with second coil with coil 2 phi B2 is equal to N2 BA. Substituting value of B here, substituting equation 1, what you will have? Phi B2 is equal to mu naught N1 N2 A over L into I. Comparing with your initial result. Phi B2 is equal to MI. What is your answer? M is equal to mu naught N1 N2 A over L. So the coefficient of mutual induction depends upon total number of coils in coil 1, total number of turns in coil 2, medium between the coils, and area of cross section of coil 2. That's how you can do mutual induction and calculate mutual induction.